Welcome to Going Carnivore in Thailand, day 15. Well, did I lose any weight today? Morning weigh-in? No. Minus 0.1 kilos. Not gaining weight. I mean, not losing weight. I actually picked up 0.1 kilo. But at the time of my weigh-in, I had ate that brisket the night before. And I don't think any of it left me, so it's more impossible that that was the culprit. But today, a little something different. So far, it's about 3 in the afternoon here. I haven't eaten anything yet today. Wasn't hungry. I'm listening to my stomach. Stomach says I'm hungry, then I'm hungry. It's about saying I'm hungry. It's getting close. And I think I'm going to have a nice thick 2-inch thick ribeye. Yum, yum. But we're going to do a little something different today. I'm going to do a reaction video to a YouTube video I saw from a site that does satire on. Well, I'll just let you watch it. Don't go anywhere. We'll watch it together right now.
Hello there, I'm Roger. My last name is Horton, and I'm here to tell you all about Horton's ground-up corn and rice with salt. But you already knew that, because we've spent billions of dollars advertising our edible fat shavings to kids. You remember this thing from the commercials we aired on your favorite cartoon channels right after school let out?
I'm addicted to this stuff.
True, she is. You all
are. Ain't that true.
But it tastes good.
Hortons, our hydrogenated oil sponges, are made of the freshest additives and come in a variety of flavors and shapes, like a circle, or an oval, or a cone, or a hyperbolic parabola, or whatever shape you'll buy. It's fake food, so we can make it into whatever you want. Here, how about this? We put them all together because it doesn't actually matter.
No wonder I'm fat.
Nothing will stop you from eating food that's so processed it no longer contains any ingredient that resembles actual food.
You'll but it does taste good.
More of it to feel as full as if you'd just eaten an apple or something your body was meant to actually process.
I'm not sure we were meant to process the apples.
Because once you start eating it, your brain will go on autopilot, and before you know it, you'll have eating an entire bag, and you'll feel just like the garbage you just made. Why did I eat all that crap? Oh,
absolutely.
Look, this ground up corn is salt as fish. We know exactly what to add to our chemical crackers to make you tick and keep on ticking. It's not a sense of keeping you alive. More like we've spent millions in funded research geared toward finding out how to make you and your family resemble rats on cocaine. No, it just took a little sugar. We did, since 1960, but we paid researchers to hide the evidence. No wonder our special ground-up corn and rice with sugar is flying off the shelves. Look, they're shaped like tiny little sugar cubes. What is a sugar cube? Get that to marketing.
And sugar.
We're not spending money brainwashing your kid into thinking these virtual bags of waste products should be part of their diet. We're spending it on lobbyists who keep you from actually knowing what's in the food we've trained you to buy.
Oh, Mom, can I get some ground corn, rice, with sugar? Please, please, please?
Fine, but we're getting this low-fat, low-sodium, healthy ground-up corn and rice with sugar.
A mother trying to fight against the years of advertising we've shoved into her daughter's brain. Even though you try to get your kids to eat healthier, we've spared no expense hiding the actual nutrition facts from you. Whether it's intentionally making our food labels confusing with measurements no Americans currently use to cook, using lobbyists to stop bills that would make our food labels more transparent, or paying researchers to claim our products don't cause childhood obesity, we're years ahead of you.
Twinkies and a Hostess cupcakes.
Got that. Don't try. Also, our healthy ground up corn and rice with sugar has three times the sugar of regular ground up
Fritos.
Corn and rice.
Who doesn't like Fritos?
The salt and fat we took out of it.
Really?
Really. But here at Horton Food, we don't just care about making cheap food quickly for maximum consumption. We care about your family, which is why we work hard to stay in your children's school lunches and cafeterias so that we can increase brand loyalty and stay a permanent part of your family's routine.
Hey, that's the guy who gives ground up corn and rice and salt. Here's more!
Now, these are cocaine lab rats, and I've seen one, and I've seen many. Again, I'm Roger.
In the 60s, I don't remember there being Fritos and potato chips in the school lunches. That really started happening maybe in the 70s. Now, I never ate all that healthy to begin with. But when I was young, when I was, you know, I don't know, 13 years old, that sort of age, I was not overweight. I mean, I didn't eat a lot of school lunches. But when I did gravitate towards the bad stuff. Because they actually cooked real mac and cheese. And if you could find the pieces where it was burnt on the top, it was really good. And I think they used real cheese on the pasta to make the mac and cheese. Not like that Kraft mac and cheese that comes out of a little box now that even I say tastes like shit. I mean, the only thing tastes worse than the Kraft macaroni and cheese that comes out of a box might be SpaghettiOs. And that ain't no joke. I know you may think it was a joke, but I remember when I was 17, had my own apartment in Cincinnati. My number one item to eat at home was open a can of SpaghettiOs.
SpaghettiOs. Want spaghetti but don't have time to make it? Just grab a can of SpaghettiOs. Step 1. Use a can opener to open the can of SpaghettiOs. Put it on the edge and squeeze. When it pops, turn the handle. Keep turning. When you're all the way around, carefully remove the lid. Sometimes you have to twist it off, like this. 2. Pour the can of SpaghettiOs into the pot. Three. Put the pot on the stove. Set the stove to medium. 4. Set the timer for 5 minutes. Go to 10 and then back to 5. 5. Use the wooden spoon to stir every once in a while. This keeps the SpaghettiOs from burning. 6. Wait until the bell rings. Then turn the stove off and remove the pot. 7. Use the ladle to pour SpaghettiOs into the bowls. Tastes like spaghetti without all the work.
Pour it in a pan, stick it on the range, turn the range on, get the little SpaghettiOs a-bubbling, a-bubbling, bubbling, and eat it. No wonder I'm fat ass now. What kind of habits were that? I mean, if that don't make you laugh, what the guy just did, I mean, I'll put a link down there to the where this video was. A little bit light today. Y'all have a great day. We'll see you tomorrow, 8:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time.
That's all, folks.